Okay, good evening to everybody. Just wait for a minute. Okay, let me see the chat. Yes. So now, can you see my screen as well as me? Okay, let us start. Okay, let us start. Let me first start with, I think, are you aware that I have started uploading YouTube videos? Voice is not audible. Is my voice audible? Tell me if it is audible. If my voice is audible, please let me know. Okay, for most of you, it is audible. Dheeraj always says not clearly. Okay, for most of you, it is audible. Okay, how many of you have subscribed to my YouTube channel? Those who have not subscribed, please go and subscribe now so that and you immediately, and also there is a bell button, you can click that bell button. Yeah, I can see only few of you have subscribed. So what I'll be doing after each lecture, I'll be uploading the video. I got the feedback that maybe some of you have not been able to attentively attend this because of the internet connection. And that is why I am now recording all this. The earlier one also I have to work upon, and I'll upload all my lecture series, which I am taking up online. Will that help? Tell me, will that help? Help or not help? Write down in the chat box. Okay. Jinas, I was asking that will the recording sharing of recording of online lectures on YouTube, will it help or not? Okay, let us move on. What we have discussed till now, and today we'll try to finish off with this article. Okay, we have discussed brand positioning. We have talked about what is brand positioning, how bigger brands have been able to establish their image in our minds, so strong image that whenever some of the words come to us, we strike off or we recall the name of those brand names. So we have talked about such brands. We have talked about the definition of positioning, what actually is positioning. We have talked about Aldrich and Jack Trott. We have talked about positioning statement, and all of you have made the positioning statement. Then we have talked about the concept which is known as USP. Very, very famous. We have talked with the help of some example. Then we have talked about 3C model of brand positioning: consumer analysis, competitive analysis, and company analysis. We have talked to them in detail about this 3C model. Then we have talked about process of market positioning. Steps related to market positioning, and we have talked about positioning map and how to draw that positioning map. And most of you have tried making positioning map also. And this was another assignment which you attempted, is basically where you draw out the perceptual or positioning map for your brand and competitors. And we discussed some of the examples yesterday. This is also which we discussed yesterday. Company desires sometimes positioning something else, and consumer adjust it in some other way, and company has to adjust it over a period of time. Then we started with the concept of repositioning yesterday, and we talked about some of the categories which has been repositioned over a period of time, especially about three categories we have talked about: chocolates, cinema halls, and milk. We have talked about, and we have discussed with the help of definition and the example of Pepsi how it has repositioned in US over a period of time. Then repositioning again, like positioning, you have to, in some cases it is target segment gets changed. Repositioning basically is done either due to change in market or change in environment. So repositioning, in case of repositioning, you have to just a minute. In case of repositioning, we have talked yesterday that maybe target market has to be changed, or use of that product has changed. We have discussed with the help of example of Arm and Hammer. Then value has changed over a period of time, or maybe some new product development has to be done for repositioning. And also at times competitor also may change. That is what we have discussed yesterday. Then we have moved on to the next, repositioning and identity brand. And we have discussed what is identity brand. We have talked about that identity brand is something with which consumers relate themselves. Like we have taken the example of Bullet is more about masculinity. And similarly in the in your book article, it has been given that Porsche sports car is basically known for masculine positioning. Whereas when they launched Porsche Cayenne, which is a SUV, and SUV for especially for women. So that was a repositioning of an identity brand. Think of, you may not relate yourself with Porsche, but you may be able to relate more with Bullet. Think of if Bullet comes out and Bullet starts saying in their advertisement that Bullet is not only a men's bike, but it is a female version. Bullet feminine bike also has been launched, or women feminine scooties have been launched. So what would be the reaction of the boys? Yes. What would be the reaction of the boys? Boys, can you react? Maybe in the chat box. Yes, boys. If feminine, anybody having Bullet in this group? Anybody having Bullet as of now? Yeah, Gursimran, it will be shocking. Gaurav, what will be your reaction if Bullet comes out with scooty and pink color scooty, Bullet pink color scooty? Yeah, what will be your reaction to that, Gursimran? And maybe other boys also, would you think of buying Bullet then? मजाक कर रही कंपनी. ओके, लड़के लेना बंद कर देंगे. साहिल सेस ओके ओके. सो नाउ दैट इज द चैलेंज एट टाइम्स व्हिच ब्रांड्स हैज टू ब्रांड्स फेस. लेट मी अगेन कम टू नाउ रीपोजिशनिंग. See, there are challenges always in repositioning exercise when you have to change the image. But when it has to be, challenge is much, much more if it is repositioning maybe an identity brand, like we were talking of Bullet. So what can happen in case of repositioning an identity brand? Like we were discussing, existing consumers will leave the brand. Yeah, existing consumers will leave the brand. Like some of you, Sahil was saying that ladke lena band kar denge. So people would not love to take, boys would not love to drive Bullet because maybe they'll feel ditched. That they have bought Bullet basically for because it is considered to be masculine and men's vehicle only, and if they come out, they'll feel ditched about it. Yeah, they, and that is one challenge. Or existing consumers will co-create their own meaning, will create their own meaning that maybe now they'll give certain meaning to it, that now it has not remained hamari, it is not for us. That kind of meaning existing consumers will. Or existing consumers will stay with the brand but devalue it. Kuch log kahenge, chalo Bullet rakh lete hain, abhi itna paisa lagaya, we'll not, maybe whatever we have bought, but they'll devalue it. They'll not find that kind of pride in driving Bullet. So what kind of pride they have now, they'll not face that. They'll not, because they have been known by Bullet over number of years in the college because of Bullet, that he was a Bullet guy. So they may not feel that kind of pride. The other is new consumers will not be attracted to the repositioned brand. Maybe at girls may not be attracted. Bullet? Why should I buy a Bullet scooty or scooter? How about girls? If Bullet comes out with a scooter or bike, girls, would you like to buy it? What is your reaction to this? Can you give your reaction? Okay, Gina says, we'll love it. Nancy says, no. Amrit Roop says, no. Mansi says, yes. So, a mixed reaction. So, some of the girls may love it because they feel... Okay, Kiran also says, no. Srishti also says, no. So, majority of them would not love it, but some of them would love it. So, a mixed kind of reaction is there. So new customers will not be attracted to the, so that is a challenge in repositioning. So what should marketer do? What should marketer do? So, and at times marketer have to do it, like, and I'm not joking, like in case of, now the similar scenario came with for Alan Soli. I think Alan Soli, all of you are aware of this brand. Ellen Soli. Are you aware of this brand, Ellen Soli? What does it make? What is the product of Ellen Soli? Can you give me the feedback in the chat box? Yeah. Give me the feedback of Ellen Soli in the chat box. Shirts, clothing, formal wear for men and women. We have talked about it. We started about it yesterday. And made a formal wear for men and women. But women is the new one. Earlier, it was only into male garments. I hope you are, all of you are aware of it. Yeah, you are aware of it or not? Aware or not aware? Write down in the chat box. Okay, Manisha says aware. So most of you are aware of it. Now the similar kind of challenge I hope Ellen Soli must have faced. Ellen Soli also is a kind of identity brand. Because Ellen Soli is one of the leading premium luxury clothing brand and known for formal wear. And it has remained there for in the men's space for a number of years. And males thought it as their own brand. But then when the environment changed, Indian business environment changed and lot many women started working. And lot many women started shifting from traditional dresses to the formal dresses, especially the pant shirts and pant coats, similar to what men were wearing in the offices. Ellen Soli saw it as a big opportunity. Fine. So it wanted to exploit that opportunity, but at the same time, the challenge was it doesn't want that the existing consumers leave the brand. Leave their brand. So Ellen Soli, it traveled from that formal Western wear for men to formal Western wear, unisex Western wear. And maybe what you have to do is tomorrow try to find out the story. Try to find out online how Ellen Soli launched this woman wear, when it launched, and what kind of range it started with, and try to find out more about Ellen Soli from men to a unisex formal wear brand. Try to find out that. Fine. And Ellen Soli has been able to reposition itself without leaving the existing customers. New customers, women have adopted it. One. And two, existing customers, men also has not left this. So it is a very successful repositioning story or a case study, what we can say. Yes. Try to find out what it has changed over all four pieces. So it is not only about the communication, it is also about try to find out what it has changed in their product mix, what they have changed in their pricing strategy, what they have changed in their maybe promotion and distribution also, how it has changed, and maybe how it has been successfully changed that. So if Ellen Soli can do it, I think the other brands can also do it. But you have to do it step by step. Like, let me give you one example, which is also given in the article, is Gillette. Gillette was known as a shaving blade company only. And over a period of time, Gillette changed to men's grooming. And now I think it is more of a unisex kind of grooming. But it has traveled step by step. Like, from shaving blades, it started coming out with shaving gels, shaving foams, and later on it ventured into the other product like skincare kind of products for men. Now, then, so from shaving blade, Gillette has become to men's grooming company. And over a period of time, now it has come down with female range also. Fine. So maybe we'll disconnect for a while and I'll again come back because of the time limits in the meeting. Do not worry. So till here, things are clear or not? Just give me the feedback. Clear or not clear? Okay, yes. Okay, most of you are clear about this. Okay. So let us move on to some more positioning concepts. There are two, three concepts which we'll talk about. This is positioning difference.